Olives. Jesus sent off two of the disciples with instructions. Go to the village across from you. As soon as you enter, you'll find a colt, tethered, one that has never yet been ridden. Untie it and bring it. If anyone asks, what are you doing? Say, the master needs him and will return him right away. So they went and found a colt tied to a door at the street corner, and they untied it. Some of those standing there said, what are you doing untying that colt? And the disciples replied exactly as Jesus had instructed them, and the people let them alone. They brought the colt to Jesus, spread the coats on it, and he mounted. The people gave him a wonderful welcome, some throwing their coats on the street, others spreading out rushes that they had cut in the fields. And running ahead and following after, they were calling out, Hosanna! Blessed is he who comes in God's name. Blessed the coming kingdom of our father David. Hosanna in the highest heaven.
Ripping his clothes, he yelled, do you hear that? After that,
death. Some of them started spitting at him. They blindfolded his eyes. They hit him, saying, "Who hit you? Prophesy." The guards punching and slapping him, then took him away. from Cyrene, the father of Alexander and Rufus. And they made him carry the cross. The soldiers brought Jesus to Golgotha, meaning skull hill. They offered him a mild painkiller, which is wine mixed with myrrh, but he wouldn't take it. And they nailed him to the cross. They divided up his clothes and threw dice to see who would get them. They nailed him up at 9 o'clock in the morning. The charge against him was the King of the Jews, was printed on a poster. Along with him, they crucified two criminals, one on his right and the other to his left. People passing along the road jeered, shaking their heads in mock lament. "You brag that you could tear down the temple and then rebuild it in 3 days. So show us your stuff. Save yourself. If you really God's son, come down from that cross." The high priests, along with the religious scholars, were right there, mixing it up with the rest of them, having a great time poking fun at him. "He saved others, but he can't save himself. Huh, Messiah is he? King of Israel? Then let him climb down from that cross. We'll all become believers then." Even the men crucified alongside Jesus joined in the mockery. At noon, the sky became extremely dark. The darkness lasted 3 hours. And at 3 o'clock, Jesus groaned out of the depths, crying loudly, "Eloi, Eloi, lama sabachthani," which means, my God, why have you abandoned me?" Some of the bystanders heard him said, "Listen, he's calling for Elijah." Someone ran off, soaked a sponge in sour wine, put it on a stick and gave it to him to drink, saying, "Let's see if Elijah comes to take him down." But Jesus, with a loud cry, gave his last breath. At that moment, the temple curtain ripped right down the middle. When the Roman captain standing guard in front of Jesus saw that he had quit breathing, he said, "This has to be the Son of God."
Thank you.
from a distance, the man named Mary Magdalene, Mary the mother of the younger James and Joseph, and Salome. When Jesus was in Galilee, these women followed and served him, and had come up with him to Jerusalem. Late in the afternoon, since it was the day of preparation, that is, the Sabbath eve, Joseph of Arimathea, a highly respected member of the Jewish council, came. He was one who lived expectantly, on the lookout for the kingdom of God. Working up his courage, he went to Pilate and asked for Jesus' body. And Pilate questioned whether he would be dead that soon, and called for the captain to verify that he was really dead. Assured by the captain, he gave Joseph the corpse. Having already purchased a linen shroud, Joseph then took him down, wrapped him in the shroud, placed him in a tomb that had been cut into the rock, and rolled a large stone across the opening. Mary Magdalene and Mary, the mother of Joseph, watched the burial.
Oh,
We are invited now to peace stand, and we're going to sing together the hymn, All to Jesus I Surrender.
Always.
Peace be with you.